River as we get ready for the rerun of Heat 2. So all fans that are out in the Columbia River, we need to get back up on the shore, please.
And before we had that abrupt intermission earlier on, very early on in to this Heat 2, it was really interesting to watch that action, even from the beginning, guys, where, of course, we know J. Michael Kelly won that first heat, has the 400 points, but he was really challenging Jimmy Shane there coming into turn two before Vilwalk went airborne coming out of that exit pin turn one, and so it'll be interesting to see where they pick up now.
What was interesting to watch on the video, Derek, is that it seemed like Vilwalk started to lose it a little bit just on the front stretch before he really started to enter even turn number one. That's where the boat started to take off. And it was one complete flip. Once again, swimmers, we need you out of the water, up on the shoreline. Everybody out of the Columbia River, Pasco side, Kennewick side, everybody up on shore, please.
You guys were talking about how this might change the dynamic of this particular heat. First thing we noticed, J. Michael Kelly came out of the pit area the exact same way he did last time. Came out like a house of fire, and he ran pretty quick up the first part of the back chute. Has pulled his foot a little bit. See if he doesn't slow down way up at the other end. But the other piece coming into play here is, remember, yesterday we were discussing the number change. And there goes Kelly backing it down again. Remember yesterday we discussed the number change from J. Michael Kelly's boat number 8. They've changed it to number 9. So his points get added on to the haul that Corey Peabody was driving. Why did they do that? Because there's only a couple hundred points difference between the 9 and the 1, Jimmy Shane's home street. So there's some big time national high points at play here.
And, of course, Jamie Nielsen wants to finish the heat and get points of his own. But, you know, they've come a long way with that motor mount issue. They had to thrash on that boat Friday to get it ready. And now they're out on the race course and fighting for lanes. We're at 3 minutes and 15 seconds to the rerun of Heat 2 for the Unlimited Hydroplanes, the HAPO Columbia Cup here in Hydro Cities, Tri-Cities. Glad you're along for the ride in Columbia Park on the Kennewick shoreline, over at Wade Park on the Pasco shoreline. What a great sight to see this Saturday afternoon.
That it is, as they make now the home street boat with Jimmy Shane rounding tire factory turn number 2. Man, that thing can just fly, and they all look so seamless out there. Again, J. Michael Kelly and Miss Tri-Cities hugging that inside lane, and we do have Miss Joker's Casino looking for their redemption run after they finished third. They were disqualified for falling under 80 in that first heat, so they've got a lot to fight for here as well.
Coming up the backstretch, Jimmy Shane. He's on the outside, and I think that's where he's going to stay. He set up in lane number 3 last time when they were out there with Vilwalk outside. See if Jimmy jumps to the inside, and it looks like maybe he's jumping across the DMZ. Esco Electric infield to the front stretch. Clock at 2:17.
He's early. He's early. He better have his foot in it. And well, he does. He does. Wow. He's going to come all the way down. Now he may make a hard left-hand turn. Right,
I think he's
now
going to. He is. He's going to take the turn for the Grand Prix boats over to the backside. So another Esco Electric infield incursion. Jimmy Shane heads to the backstretch. Meanwhile, on the front stretch, with a minute and 50, you've got J. Michael Kelly in the 9.
Tell me when he crosses start-finish.
And that would be now. Okay. And he's not going really fast either. And Brad, they have telemetry readings for the 80-mile-an-hour situation, correct?
Absolutely.
Okay, so it's all being monitored.
So here comes Mike down to the lower end at a buck 25 right now. I think he's in pretty good shape. He'll have to stay at 80 miles an hour for a bit. He gets right to the entrance pin now at 1:17. Then it's going to be Jamie Nielsen in the Joker's Casino. He's going to slot himself into lane number 2. Jimmy Shane's going to wind this blue and white boat up hard on the outside. Derek, he's starting to put the foot down a little bit, but we're coming up on 1 minute to the start of Heat 2.
J. Michael Kelly just coming off the exit pin of turn number 2, tire factory turn number 2 in lane number 1. Then you've got Jamie Nielsen in lane 2 on the outside. The home street with Jimmy Shane in lane number 3. Is
45 seconds. 45 seconds.
And they are directly across from the start-finish line here at the Brutzman's Memorial Barge. It's the parade lap. Do they have any indication in the cockpit on that 80-mile-an-hour situation too, Brad?
Yes, they do.
All right, so they're well aware of that when it does occur. Back up to the top end of the course into Sun Pacific Energy Shell Sun Market turn number 3. J. Michael Kelly to the apex.
15 seconds, Mark, 15.
That's the 9. Lynx Healthcare presents Miss Tri-Cities. Lane number 2, Miss Joker's Casino with Jamie Nielsen. Lane 3, Miss Madison.
5.
Home Street.
4.
The 1 with Jimmy Shane.
3, 2, 1. Mark.
It is a perfectly clean start from our vantage point. On the outside, that's where you find the boat speed. But look at Jamie Nielsen. He's in the tunnel. He's going to try to take second place away from J. Michael Kelly.
Yeah, but he's not going to be able to do it. When they get down here, absolutely dead even. And I'll tell you what, Jimmy Shane's way on the outside, Derek.
Don't know what happened to Derek in Tire Factory turn number 2, but we'll take over from here as they get to the exit pin. Jamie Nielsen really backed out of the throttle. Looks like he may have lost some power heading into Tire Factory turn number 2. So on the backstretch, you've got Shane in the lead on the outside. J. Michael Kelly, he's about, 3 boat lengths back as they come up that backstretch, the Griggs Ace Hardware backstretch, and dive into Sun Market turn number 3. Both boats into the turn to the apex with Rattlesnake Mountain. A little bit hazy this afternoon in the backdrop. They get to the exit pin of White's Furniture and Hardwoods, turn number 4. They are deck to deck. Jimmy Shane is going to squirt forward and take the lead away as they come to the start-finish line. And across at 159.061 miles per hour, it's Jimmy Shane with the lead in the home street, heading into All Doors Incorporated, turn number 1.
Home Street, Jimmy Shane walks the sponsors to the entrance pin of the corner, but Kelly staying right with him on the inside, Derek.
So it's on the inside, J. Michael Kelly with the short course around, and he was able to reel in Jimmy Shane just a little bit, but Shane starts to pull away on the backstretch. This is where you really watch on the Griggs backstretch to see which boat has the power. And right now it's Jimmy Shane in the home street, and he is starting to pull away, almost a full rooster tail lead. Now, J. Michael Kelly has the opportunity to cut into that lead as they head into Shell Sun Market turn number 3. To the apex, J. Mike with a really nice turn on the inside, hugging the buoy line, but Jimmy Shane with boat speed on the outside, and he's going to be impossible to catch in that one. Home Street, as they come across the Mosteller start-finish line. It's a half a rooster tail lead for Jimmy Shane coming down the front stretch.
Yeah, it is Jimmy Shane, and he is showing some incredible speed, and he's also letting J. Michael Kelly know, I let you get on the inside of me, and you still can't run with me. Home Street back, Jimmy Shane!
Easily a rooster tail length lead now. Sorry, guys, about that delay. We're back in action here at turn number 2. Generator ran out of fuel, but we're good. So it is that home street boat again, a rooster tail length lead over Miss Tri-Cities and J. Michael Kelly now as they enter the Griggs backstretch.
Yep, and the white flag out on the course for Jimmy Shane in heat 2 in the Miss Madison.
Jimmy Shane's first lap of 159 miles an hour. I believe that's going to be another course record in a heat qualifier, if I'm not mistaken. So it's the cream of the field right now for Jimmy Shane. Just an incredible boat ride. He's bringing it home, Mike.
And off the exit pin, White's Finished Furniture and Hardwoods, turn number 4. Jimmy Shane onto the front stretch. Checkered flag is out. Home Street gets the victory with Jimmy Shane in the Miss Madison. Second place, J. Michael Kelly in the Lynx Healthcare presents Miss Tri-Cities the 9. Jamie Nielsen just getting into turn number 3, the Shell Sun Market turn, to the apex, and now to turn number 4. Hello to our Buffalo Brothers friends upstreams. Hope you're having a good time enjoying boat racing on the Columbia River. Jimmy Shane on the outside, and he's been willing all weekend long to this point to settle for an outside lane. And Brad Luce, he showed us why. He doesn't have any problem winning from the outside.
No, he doesn't, and it sends a pretty strong message that I think you may have some work to do. Mike, if you can hold on to that right there, I got to run upstairs for a moment.
You got
it. Sorry, I had to do that. Not you, Mike, another Mike. But you're right. I mean, to be able to do that from the outside, and if he turned that at a buck 59, I just found my paperwork. I'm going to look up those numbers. It may very well be, but even if it isn't, that's what you call smoking. That boat was flying.
If I remember, 2018, 155 miles an hour in a heat race was the course record. And if this stands, he blew that out of the water by 4 miles an hour.
Yeah, he sure did. So we'll take a look at the numbers. So I'm headed down now. We will go down. I know Glenn Vaughan is already down there. So yeah, we will have reaction from both J. Michael Kelly and Jimmy Shane.
Hey, Brad, of the fuel-restricted records for Tri-Cities, it was 2018 with Andrew Tate, 155.504.
So the 159, if that holds, that's a new record.
Yeah, I'm
for Tri-Cities.
Staring right at those same numbers. Wow.
Great run.
It might be interesting to take a look at.
That's right. I'm
out. Yeah. Pete David holds that fuel-restricted record for a three-lap heat at a buck 52. So it might be interesting to see just how fast what the average might have been for the heat. But we got the cart in front of the horse. That's an awfully fast lap, no matter how you slice it. And he did it from the outside.
And
that's
his,
the other key.
His three-lap speeds were 159 and change. On lap number two, he clocked at a 153 and 152 on the final lap. So average is about 153.5.
Three-lap heat, fuel-restricted record, 152.753. So, again, if it stands, we've got to have the boats go through tech inspection. And so it's unofficial, but it's on the water. That was quite a performance by Jimmy Shane, and the U won the Miss Home Street. Wasn't half bad from J. Michael Kelly. Driving the Lynx Healthcare presents Miss Tri-Cities.
I think it'll be a competitive Sunday. I think they're going to put all the work that they need to put in. These guys just live and breathe this sort of thing, and we'll see the fruits of their labor tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. for sure.
Well, and how about Austin Egret in the 12? What a great job for Local 598 and the Plumbers and Steam Fitters, and all the work that they did to the bottom of that boat when it fell into a hole and had some damage.
Well, it took most of the afternoon, but we got a couple of really good boat races in today.
No question. The Greg Hopp duel with awesome Austin Egret, that was amazing.
I did get an opportunity to ask Austin about that a little bit, and he says, well, I'm just trying to put on a good show for the fans. I got a flair for the dramatic, dude.
That was a really great finish. And Greg Hopp, whatever they did, and I think they mentioned they tried a different motor called Happy, and I'm sure they're all smiling down there.
Right. Hey, Michael.
You got it, Glenn.
We've got J. Michael Kelly. Wow, that was a great finish to that delayed second heat. How'd things run out there?
I mean, it was a heck of a race. Could have been a little faster, but, you know, the home street boat's pretty fast. You know, we got this 9 boat going pretty good, so we'll go look at some other stuff and see if we need to catch those guys.
Well, you got a first place in the first seed, second place. That's not necessarily something to cry about.
Oh, not at all. I mean, these guys have been working hard. It was a hard-earned second place finish, and you know, we'll just keep on chipping away. We're not going to give up. We got to get faster so we can go out there and put on a good show for these guys.
And Ken, those points is awfully important as well.
Correct. I mean, if you don't get those points and you don't finish, it makes it pretty hard to go racing that final.
Day two in the books. How are you feeling? How's your team feeling?
I mean, we feel great. We're happy with the boat ride. The boat's showing great speed. We just got to take care of it and, you know, get it ready for this final or for the final.
All right. J. Michael Kelly, thanks for the time.
Glenn Boggan, our American Radiator Pit reporter. Brad Luce, I believe, is probably closing in now on Jimmy Shane.
I am, but there was this very large 32-foot-long powder blue and white machine that's going over my head. I'm looking at Jimmy. He's just up the dock from me here. What was that hot lap? A buck 59?
Yep.
Okay. 159.061.
Hang on a sec.
You got it. Yeah, that's a good way to come out of the chute in lap number one, isn't it?
Yeah, and he nailed the start.
Yeah,
I mean, it was a perfect start.
Perfect start, I'm being told from the guys up there. You were in an outside lane, just wound the thing up, and man, did it respond.
Yeah, that's the type of start I was looking for in the final heat last year here in Tri-Cities, and I did not do that type of a start in the final heat last year. So it was nice to have a couple good starts the last two heats. It gives me confidence, and I can build on our timing marks, and it's really going to lead us into the final heat. So Miss Homestreet's performing flawlessly. It's amazing.